want to begin with saying that I've been drawing since I was a child, and I started from my mother's newly decorated room walls, and now I'm taking academic arts courses. I've tried many different things like architecture, photography, traditional art, digital art, graphic design. Well, being an artist sounds fun, doesn't it? Of course it can be fun, but it can also be exhausting. The most exhausting thing probably is for young artists finding themselves in the fields of art. So, art is a term which can be very general. So in order to make it a lot more easier for us, let's imagine art as a house. So if art is a house, then particles or terms which make up art, such as photography, architecture, and so on, they can be considered as rooms. And now all one has to do is to find in which room do they feel the most comfortable in, because comfort is essential for an artist. However, the way of finding yourself in the fields of art can be a very rocky path. Hence the name of this TED Talk. I am a very anxious person, and finding myself in the fields of art hasn't made my life any easier. I would always feel nauseous when I couldn't finish a drawing at time, or when I couldn't draw exactly what I had in my mind. It was the worst experience when my architectural construction wasn't nearly as good as the rest of my teammates, or it wasn't a total perfection. And mind that it was made from uncooked spaghetti, and I don't know why I expected perfection, but I just did. So, fun story. I was visiting my sister in London, and naturally, I took both of my cameras, and God, I absolutely loved walking around the streets, photographing whatever I liked, and there was no one to boss me around, so it was total perfection. But my happiness didn't last for too long, because I like to upload my art on social media, and this time was no exception. I mean, I was in London, and look at the pictures I'd taken. I posted one of my pictures online, and guess who texted me? Well, my photography teacher did, and he was in London, and he suggested that we meet up and have a photography session. Nothing too special, right? But imagine being me, an anxious teenager who suddenly forgot how to use a camera. All I wanted to do was to hide in the dark corner and just forget that photography even existed. Fortunately for me, I replied that yes, that would be wonderful. Let's meet up. I am glad that I took that opportunity, because my photography teacher is a professional, and to have a photography session or even a lesson with him is one of the greatest opportunities a beginner can have. So the next thing was to meet him at the right spot, on the right place. And mind that I was not very familiar with the streets, but I think I have to thank my anxiety for this one, because I was so nervous that I turned up 15 minutes earlier. You see what happened here? Anxiety didn't hold me back. And I'm not going to lie to you, this whole overcoming anxiety thing might take awfully long time, but I promise you that through small steps, you will see yourself develop as an artist and even as a person. And by small steps, I mean that, of course, you're allowed to say no. And I've said no maybe a dozen of times. So what if you're missing a good opportunity? As a young artist, you will soon realize that opportunities come and go. There are plenty of them. And if there are none, you can always go and create one for yourself. For example, I will bring a good example now. And when I was first getting into photography, my parents noticed my interest, and they offered that I took some professional courses, and I was afraid to death. All I knew was that I pressed a button, and boom, there was a nice picture. And with that knowledge, I wasn't too happy about attending professional classes, sitting in the class with a bunch of kids who knew what they were doing, and a teacher who, in my opinion, would have thought that I was an idiot. But I still wanted to know my way in photography, so as an 11-year-old with a camera filled with buttons I knew nothing about, I began to teach myself. And once I started to believe in myself and to believe in my knowledge, I took that offer and I began taking those classes. And it wasn't scary at all, of course. I got to know lots of interesting people, and my teacher taught me lots of things which I then used in my photography project about old buildings in Old Tbilisi, but we'll get into that a bit later. Saying no does not mean instant failure. And now that I've mentioned failure, you have to know that it's okay to fail too, because as an artist, you'll do so a lot. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I failed a lot more. I fail a lot more than I succeed. Even the greatest artists fail, and there is nothing to be ashamed of. And I want to tell you that pressuring yourself into creating perfection doesn't work nearly as good as failing your way up to perfection does. I'm going to bring an example. A few years ago, I had a failed attempt at drawing buddies. And that completely stopped my process of development because I never wanted to go back to that again. And I just stuck with what I already knew. And I had to talk myself into trying something new because every time my world every time I failed, my world crashed. And I felt really bad. But what I didn't know was that every single time my world crashed, a new one was building up. And that was the process of me learning on my own mistakes. And that was the outcome. I've talked a lot about failure, so let's move on a bit to success. An artist's proud moment is when they finally succeed in finishing their artwork. And I tend to leave stuff unfinished because I do not have the emotional capacity to finish something that I don't like. And last year, when I was in MYP year 10, I had to make a mandatory personal project. And the theme that I had chosen for myself was Unknown History of Buildings in Old Tbilisi. That project involved lots of photography and going out, exploring, and that was too much for me because it was lots of communicating, gaining and developing new skills, interviewing, and if we link this back to the theme of my TED Talk, it was a very triggering thing to me. But I deep down, I knew that if I just put a little bit more effort into this, my project would have turned out just great. And I went on photographing, doing everything that I could. And when it was finally time to finish this project, I was proud of myself, and I was proud of what I had done. And in the end, I would like to say that it is you that matters the most. You have to try and make yourself proud and not others. And one day, you might just do something that your younger self found impossible. Thanks for listening to my TED Talk, and I hope you found this speech inspirational and motivational. Thank you.